In front of you there are two boxes. Box 1 is transparent and contains £1,000. Box 2 is opaque and contains either £1,000,000 or nothing. You are given the following choice. Either you can take what is in both boxes, or you can take only what is in the second box. However, before you are presented with this choice, a supercomputer which has the power to predict your choices with an unerring accuracy adds the following catch. If the computer predicts that you will open both boxes, then it will put nothing in box 2. If it predicts that you will choose to open only the second box, then it puts £1,000,000 in the box. The supercomputer has carried out this test hundreds of times and has never made a wrong prediction. So the sequence of events are as follows. The supercomputer makes its prediction, and based on this prediction it either puts £1,000,000 into box 2 or leaves it empty. You then make your choice. What do you choose? Created by William Newcomb and first published by Robert Nozick in 1969, the problem has been dividing people for the last 50 years. You might be thinking that the answer is obvious, and that there's no actual problem here. However, in a recent poll of over 31,000 people, 53.5% chose to open box 2, and 46.5% chose to open both boxes. So why are people so divided on this question? Let's find out. At the heart of Newcomb's paradox is a conflict between two principles of decision theory, the expected utility principle and the dominance principle. But before we look at these, let's look at the standard arguments for being a one-boxer or a two-boxer. If I decide to take what is in both boxes, then the supercomputer will have almost certainly predicted this and will have left the second box empty, leaving me with only £1,000. But if I decide to just take what's in the second box, then the supercomputer will have predicted this and put the £1,000,000 inside, leaving me much richer. I should therefore choose to take only what is in the second box. But, a two-boxer will say, when you make your decision, standing in front of the boxes, the supercomputer has already made its prediction and has therefore already placed the million inside box 2 or has left it empty. Therefore, taking both boxes can only maximise your reward, as you would either get £1,000,000 plus £1,000 or zero plus £1,000. Whatever the supercomputer has predicted, you will end up with £1,000 more by choosing both boxes. The options and outcomes of the problem can be shown in a payoff matrix. Here we can clearly see that taking both boxes will leave you with more money, whichever prediction the supercomputer has made. In decision theory, this follows the dominance principle, which states that if one strategy is always better, no matter the circumstances, then it is rational to choose that strategy. However, this contradicts the expected utility principle, which states that the rational choice is the one which has the maximal expected utility, or value, to you. We can work out the expected utility of each action by multiplying each of its mutually exclusive outcomes by the probability of the outcome, given the action. Let's say, being conservative, that the supercomputer can predict the future with a 90% accuracy. We can then work out the expected utility of both actions, like so. We can see, therefore, that using the expected utility principle, the rational choice is to choose to open only the second box. So we have two rational but contradictory answers. Still not sure if you're a one-boxer or a two-boxer? Well, consider the following. Suppose your friend is taking the experiment and chooses to open just the second box. But before the box is opened, you are asked to place a bet on whether there will be £1,000,000 inside. Given the success of the supercomputer in correctly predicting the outcome in hundreds of previous tests, you would surely bet that inside the box was £1,000,000. Likewise, if your friend chose to open both boxes, wouldn't you bet that box 2 is empty? Now suppose that the back of box 2 is transparent, and from where you stand you can see what's inside both boxes. Your friend taking the experiment can still only see inside box 1 and the £1,000. Assuming you want the best for your friend, you would want him to open both boxes, regardless of what's in box 2. If the £1,000,000 is in the box, it's not suddenly going to disappear if he chooses to open both. It seems that the logical thing to do would be to open both boxes, but is that how you would actually act if given the opportunity? Click on the poll in the top right-hand corner to make your choice, and let me know how you voted and why down in the comments. Hey, thanks for watching. Have you ever heard about the dancing plague of 1518, where over 400 people danced wildly around the city of Strasbourg until they collapsed or died from exhaustion? Click here to find out why. Or if you want to watch some more Paradox videos, then check out this playlist here. See you next time.